case of using this here through the looper and then into the 909, yeah, via the Sakai MIDI cable. Yeah, you don't need to use any of these songs or any of these tracks inside the 909. That doesn't really matter because we're using the audio input, yeah, mix in, sample, resample, sampling. Yeah, you can put mic in if you want, stick it mic in, and then you press mix in and hold. Okay, you just okay, then mix in and hold, and then slide down to velocity pads. Okay, so that means the velocity pads will play the audio via the MIDI cable here. So if I press a note here, say C, the C comes up on there. Okay, if I press hold on any note, then that will mean the audio, whatever I play, will come in and it will hold. So anything that I sample or anything that I do here, the looper, into the looper, will come out to the input on the 909 here. And then there you go. Righto. So that's the Monotron sound here, output into the mixer here. From the mixer it then comes out into the tone works, where I can put some effects on it, like so, chorus. And then after that, that comes out into the looper. And I can add extra effects on the looper if I so wish. For example, I have a pedal here. I could just add some delay on it and just play it up and down the keys. And then we can just adjust the sound accordingly using. Glorious MS20 filter. And we can just put another delay on it if you want. All sorts of other effects on here. Okay, but we're not going to use any effects. That's not the whole thing for this. We're not using effects today on that. One of an MS-20 filter. Okay, so we can switch off the hold button there a minute. In fact, you can actually use an arpeggiator as well on here. Latch it on. So we now have the arpeggiator here, MIDI'd out to MIDI in, and we can just change the sound. And the arpeggiator on the Akai MIDI controller is playing the notes on the 909, well, the audio gate on the 909, allowing the Monotron to go through. Okay, so what we can actually do, we'll try looping it. Okay, we have the Monotron Duos. So the Monotron Duo goes into the second mixer. So we've latched it now. We've latched it onto the arpeggiator, so now the Monotron has basically been sequenced in a kind of primitive audio fashion. And we can use the duo as well. Adding a little bit of X effect. Off the whole button, and you can just use it whenever you want to use it. So if you wanted to use the drums, for example, the drums should be going through there. I don't know why they're not. There they are. Okay, so put it on hold. Pocket operator. Okay, loop this. Try the drums first. Try loop the drums first. Maybe try the drums first. Maybe it'd be a good idea. Looped perfectly. Now we'll add some bass on it or something. So we've now looped the bass. Turn off the drums. Okay. So we can layer on top of anything we want. So that's basically just looping a few things from here, straight through, looped onto there. Okay, that's a matter of interest. So what you can also do is you can run this out into here and then back out to wherever, so that you can actually add filter effects to that, which we'll probably do another time anyway. Alright. Yeah, right, part two of this. is a different setup. At the moment we've got this running into there. What we want is to be able to play a sequence using this and recording output of this into the Monotron. So you're actually recording a sequence in the looper via the audio gate system on the MC909. We'll just set that up. Okay, we've made a small drum loop. Like so. Yeah. We can add some bass synths from here using this here and the MC909. So you can actually loop that now if you want to, so you can loop it. So now that's looping. We've looped that bit. So we can change the sound, we can overdub it. Change of sounds. I'll put it on a hold. Arpeggiator. Mm-hmm. Alright, that'll do. Try that out anyway. Just an idea what stuff shit can do. On the 909, linking stuff through and doing that. Okay, so talk to you later then.